Let's move on to debt service coverage ratio and analysis. See, debt service coverage ratio is a ratio which is going to measure the repayment capacity of the borrower. So how this repayment capacity is measured? We know it is debt service coverage ratio, but again that is divided into three. We have gross DSCR, okay, then we have net DSCR, and we also have average of gross DSCR, average of net DSCR. So within debt service coverage ratio itself, we have almost four types of debt service coverage ratios. So what is gross DSCR, what is net DSCR? Let's see. When we say gross DSCR, we are going to consider the gross cash flows available for servicing the total repayment obligation. Okay, so we can say gross cash accruals. So what is gross cash accruals? It is PAT minus dividend plus depreciation plus interest on term loan whole divided by interest on term loan plus principal repayment. Okay, so this makes gross DSCR. Public sector banks will be insisting it should be at least 1.75, or some banks will go up to the down level up to 1.5. then comes net DSCR. What is net DSCR? Here focus is on the cash flows that are available for servicing the principal. It means we'll take PAT minus dividend plus depreciation divided by principal repayment, divided by principal repayment. In general, this net DSCR will always be greater than gross DSCR, because gross DSCR is also looking at the servicing of interest. Okay, whereas here from these cash flows we are focused only on servicing of principal. Okay, so this ratio is expected to be higher than gross DSCR. Okay, so if minimum gross DSCR is expected at 1.75, net DSCR should be greater than 1.75. if minimum is expected to be 1.5, net should be greater than 1.5, and obviously it will be greater. Okay, so some banks will prescribe level like net DSCR should be at least 2 times or 1.75 times, as the case may be. Okay, now let's take a real DSCR computation of a original company. Look at here, you are given the DSCR computation. It is DSCR computation for how many years? Year 1 to 8. Year 1 to 8. And for information purpose, only for information purpose, not for calculation purpose, net sales are given 27.6 crore and expected to increase to 82 crore, and after that it is freezed. Okay, so it is freezed here. It means no year-on-year increase in net sales are projected. Okay, this is basically on the conservative side, but in reality year-on-year it can increase, but here the bank is going on very very conservative calculation. Okay, so there is almost 10 plus crore increase from 27.6 to 38.82 crore. Okay, fine. Now here you have the net cash accrual calculation. This is something which they have picked up from CMA. So what is net cash accrual? It is PAT minus dividend plus depreciation. Okay, so when they did this calculation, they got 4.49, 6.1, 6.14, 5.71, 5.98, 6.24, 6.72. So for 8 years we have, and all this added together is 47.87 crore. This attains significance especially when we are looking at gross average DSCR, which you will understand shortly. So this is net cash accrual. With this net cash accrual, term loan interest is now added. If you recollect, here I have said it is PAT minus dividend plus depreciation plus interest on term loan. That interest on term loan is what we are writing separately here. So this is the term loan interest, which is again picked up from CMA. Okay, now these two are added. So total sources is nothing but item number 1 plus 2. So we have total sources. This is total source for year 1 to 8. And if you can notice, it shows some kind of a fluctuating level. Look at here, 6.77, it goes to 8.75, then it comes down every year. It comes down every year, and it is coming back almost to the same level, like 6.79. Okay, and why this is happening? This may happen because net cash accrual is influenced by depreciation. Okay, and year after year, when you add back depreciation, the depreciation levels, that is going to have impact. And look at the term loan interest also. The term loan interest is coming down year after year, so that's also having impact, right? So this is total sources. Then let us have a look at the total installments. Let's see. Yeah. Now we'll focus on obligation. The first one is term loan installment. That is, what is the repayment fixed for each and every year? This is something which we have to pick up from the repayment schedule. I mean, existing loan repayment schedule, proposed loan repayment schedule, everything should be added here. And if you can notice, all 8 year figures added works out to 22 crore. Then term loan interest, and this term loan interest is nothing but what we have already captured over here. Okay, whatever we have captured over here, that is again coming back here. So in the numerator also it is factored. Look at here, in the numerator also it is factored, and denominator also it should be factored. Okay, so in the denominator also you can see the term loan interest, same numbers, 2.28, 2.28, 2.6, 2.6, like that. For each and every year we have that, and eventually check the total, 11.7 crore. Now let us total the uses. We'll total the uses, that is sum of these two, 3.85, 5.8, it goes. And so we have the total uses as 33.7 crore. Okay. Now let me clear all this. Yeah. So this is the total source and this is the total use. If this total source is divided by total use, what you get is gross DSCR, because this is nothing but PAT minus dividend plus depreciation plus term loan interest divided by term loan interest plus term loan principal repayment. Okay, so that gives gross DSCR. So 6.77 divided by 3.85 gives you the ratio as 1.76. It is good because it is greater than 1.75, which many public sector banks will insist. But certain banks are okay if it is greater than 1.5. So here, this DSCR table is picked up from the bank, which is accepting DSCR at the 1.5 level. Okay, so for them, in year 1, this 1.76 is an attractive ratio. Look at year 2. They had source of 8.75, whereas repayment obligation is only 5.8 crore. So 8.75 divided by 5.8, you get 1.51. But still, this is okay for that bank because it is greater than 1.5, because I told you this bank accepts DSCR at 1.5 level. Year 3, 8.36, whereas total uses are 5.36. So 8.36 divided by 5.36, it is 1.56. That is the DSCR. 8.36 by 5.36, it is 1.56. It is also greater than 1.50. And if you notice, every year the ratio is maintained above 1.5. But why it is high in first year and it is coming down in year 2, 3, 4? Let's analyze. Let me see. Sorry. Yeah. See, in year 2, sources have increased actually. From 6.77, it has gone to 8.75. But on the other side, look at the term loan installment. It got doubled. Okay. Term loan interest also increased. So the increase from loan, that is 8.75 minus 6.77, the increase is only 1.98 crore. But here, if you note the increase, 5.8 minus 3.85, it is 1.95. Okay, so there is almost equal increase. That's why DSCR could not be maintained at the same level. See, denominator should come down ideally. When numerator increases and when denominator is also increasing at the same level, DSCR will come down only. When numerator increases, the denominator remains same, DSCR will increase. But here both of them almost moved in same direction, so DSCR has moved in opposite direction. And look at here, from 8.75 it is coming down. When it is going up itself, the ratio is not improving, it is coming down. And one relief is total uses has come down. Okay, so that is going to give a relief. And that's the reason from 1.51, it had increased to 1.56. Okay, fine. Then in year 4, it is coming down even further. And to the rescue, uses is also coming down. This is coming down, which is bad sign. This is coming down, which is a good sign. That's why the ratio is maintained above 1.5 itself. Then in year 5, sources 7.32. Uses are 4.48, so now it is on improving trend and it is improving year after year. So what we should be concerned is whether the net cash accrual is showing a dip. See, from 4.49 it has increased to 6.1, 6.14. From there it had come down to 5.71 in year 4. Why it is coming down? Because DSCR is lowest only at these two points, 1.51 and 1.5. Okay, only at these two points DSCR is at its lowest. So why this net cash accrual is coming down in year 4, that got to be analyzed and brought out in the proposal. Okay, but if you notice, throughout gross DSCR is maintained above the generally expected level of 1.5. okay, so this is gross DSCR. We also have the concept called gross average DSCR. How this gross average DSCR is calculated? See, look at here, you had net cash accrual, right? This net cash accrual for all the years are added here. Then term loan interest for all the years, that is also added. 47.87 plus 11.70 gives you 59.57. this is total source. Similarly, total installments are here, total interest is here. If you add these two, you get 33.7. so 59.57 is the total source for this project period and 33.7 is the total use. So 59.57 divided by 33.70 gives you the ratio as 1.77. so gross average DSCR is greater than 1.5, which some public sector banks are okay with. It is also greater than 1.75. so gross average DSCR is expected to be satisfactory, but it is very close to the expected level. So sanctioning authorities may have some apprehension whether these numbers are really cooked up to get the minimum ratio. Okay, so you should have a solid justification whether these numbers are reasonable. Okay, whether these numbers are achievable. Then comes net DSCR. Net DSCR, as already I said, it is going to focus only on principal repayment. That's why you are going to take only the cash accruals before adding this interest on term loan, and that is compared only with principal repayment. Look at here, this is your cash accrual, 4.49, and this is your principal repayment. 4.49 divided by 1.57 is giving you 2.86. this is your net debt service coverage ratio. 6.10 divided by 3.14 will give you 1.94. like that you can calculate for each and every year. And look at the total net cash accrual, 47.87, and what is the total term loan installment? 22. 47.87 divided by 22, let's see, 47.87 divided by 22 will give you 2.18, and this is the average net debt service coverage ratio. So this is how gross DSCR, net DSCR, ग्रॉस एवरेज डीएसीआर, नेट एवरेज डीएसीआर और कैलकुलेटेड।
Thanks for watching this video and I hope you like this lecture. If you wish to learn more on the areas related to this topic, check our comprehensive course. I have shared the details and link in the description below. Click, sign up and enroll. I'll see you inside the course.